Hey students, in this video we are going to start with our warm-up first. So I want you to simplify this expression, and then I want to see if you can find the area of this rectangle. And this is just practicing what we recently talked about in class last week and this week. So for the first question, I want you to think about, here I have negative exponents. What exactly should we do when we see negative exponents? How can I rewrite this expression so that the exponents are positive? If you said that we need to move the x to the negative power to the denominator so that it can become positive 2, and the x to the negative third to the numerator so it can become positive 3, you will be correct. After we rewrite our expression so that it contains only positive exponents, then and only then we can go through the process of simplifying this expression. So if you write that out, hopefully you remember that this is x 3 times and a y. And we have x 2 times and 2y's, and you can go through and start to eliminate or cross out your x's, and you have a single x left, and then your y's, and you have a single y left. So for the area, we know that to find area, we need to take the base multiplied by the height for a rectangle. And so this is the base, this is the height. You can set that up like we did in class yesterday and also on Monday as well. So I can see that I want to take this 3x term and distribute it to x squared and also to negative 2. I can show that distribution here with these arrows. So 3x times x squared, I can write it out like this, 3x times 1x squared. And I can also show the distribution here with the red arrow to the negative 2. I have 3x times negative 2, so I can write that here, and then we just simplify it. So 3 times 1, 3, and then x times x squared is going to be x cubed. And then 3 times negative 2 is negative 6, so I can write minus 6, and then we just bring the x along. So that is the warm-up for today. It was similar to the warm-up yesterday, and go ahead and hit you with another warm-up just like it to see if you were more successful today than you were yesterday. For our lesson today, we are going to learn about the box method and how we can use the box method to simplify algebraic expressions. And so here, we kind of have a similar setup to the warm-up, where we were multiplying a monomial times a binomial. But if you look at this problem, it's a little different because we have a binomial that we want to multiply by another binomial. And so I'm going to show you a different way how you can multiply this binomial times this binomial, since we have two terms in front of this one. And it's going to be the box method. And so if you have biology, then you have already learned what a Punnett square is and how to fill out the boxes from a Punnett square. If you don't have biology, then you're in for a treat today, because I'm going to show you that Punnett square method. In algebra 1, we call it the box method. So first, we want to start with our box, and doesn't matter what size box you draw, you just need to draw a rectangular box or even a square. And then we want to divide the box in half, and then in half again. So we want to create these four boxes to represent these four terms here in our expression. And now my first binomial, I'm actually going to write that on top of the box. So I'm going to take the 3n, write it above this first little box, and I'm going to take the minus 4 and write it above the second one. And I'm going to take my second binomial, and that's going to be written along the side of the box here. So I'm going to take my n and my positive 1 and write that there. And so if you are familiar with the Punnett square and biology, then you know that the number that goes in here is the product of the numbers that are on the outside of that particular box. If you don't know that, then we can think of this as an area model. I'm taking this edge or this term, and I'm multiplying it by this term to get the value that goes inside this first box. So if I have 1n, and I'm multiplying it by 3n, well, 1 times 3, that's 3, and then n times n is n squared. And I'm going to repeat that same process for each box until the boxes are filled up with the product of the outside terms. So in this box over here, I'm going to go back to the one in, but since this box is underneath the -4, I'm going to take one in times -4. So one times -4 is -4. And then I just write my n because there's no other n in this term. So it's just -4n. And so now I move down here and I have positive 1 times 3n. So 1 times any number or any term stays the same, 3n. And then I take that 1 and multiply it by the 4. Since this 1 is in front or on the same row as this box and this -4 is above this one, so 1 times -4, that's just -4. So now once I have the box filled in, I can look at, well, now I can write each term out outside of the box, and then I can look at combining my like terms. So I can use the box to find the product of this binomial and this binomial. This would be 3n squared minus 4n plus 3n minus 4. I'm taking each one of these terms, and I'm writing it out, so then I can combine like terms. You notice here the middle terms, those are my like terms, and I can combine those. This term and this term are my like terms, so -4n plus 3, that's going to be -1n, and I can just bring down my 3n squared and my minus 4. And this is going to be my answer for when I multiply this binomial times this binomial. This is my answer here. So I'm going to do another one with you before I have you do one on your own. So let's look at this one. Same problem. I want to draw out my box. So let's make our box. And then I want to divide this box into four parts. And I have a binomial times a binomial. So I'm going to take this first binomial and just write each term above each of these kind of partitioned off sections of the box. So 6h minus 2. And then I'm going to take my second binomial and I'm going to write that on the side of the box, 2h minus 3. And I'm going to go through and start multiplying the outside numbers together. So if I look at this, I have 2h times 6h. Well, 2 times 6, that's 12. And h times h is h squared. And I repeat that same process. 2h times negative 2, well, that's negative 4h. And I go on to my negative 3 down here. Negative 3 times 6h is negative 18h. And then negative 3 times negative 2, that's going to be a positive 6. And once I have my box filled out, now I can look at writing each term down below it so we can combine like terms. So 12h squared minus 4h minus 18h plus 6. And this is my like term with this one. And once I combine those two like terms, you could do this in your calculator, I have negative 4 minus 18. So if you don't know what that is, then go to your calculator. Cancel. So you could do negative 4 and minus 18, and you get negative 22. So when I go back to this problem, that's going to be negative 22h, and I will bring down my positive 6, and I will bring down my 12h squared. So I want you to try this one, see if you can construct the box, and see if you can figure out what the product is, your final answer, after you construct the box to use it to arrive at this final answer. So for this problem, we want to make sure that we've made this box here, and I've written out the 2m, the minus 1, the 3m, and the minus 7 on the outside. And then we go through and we multiply. So this is what you should have gotten. 3 times 2 is 6, m times m is m squared, 3 times negative 1 is negative 3, and we just bring that m along. Negative 7 times 2 is negative 14, and I bring that m along. negative 7 times negative 1 is positive 7. And I write all my terms down. So 6m squared from the first box, negative 3m from the second box, negative 14m from this one, and plus 7. And then I combine my like terms. So this negative 17m comes from the middle terms here. So I can combine my like terms. And then that's my final answer, because I can't combine the 6m squared with the 17m or the 7. So this is my answer when I multiply this binomial times this binomial. All right, let's look at another example, but this one looks a little different. We should know that anytime I see squared, that gives me some instructions, and that tells me I need to write this out twice. So if I write this out twice, I have 2x minus 4 times 2x minus 4. And then from there, we're going to utilize the box method to multiply this out. So I draw my line, and then I can write 2x minus 4, another 2x minus 4, and I go through and I multiply everything out. So 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 2x times negative 4 is negative 8x. Negative 4 times 2x is negative 8x. And then negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16. So when I put that back together, 4x squared minus 8x minus 8x plus 16. And then my like terms are in the middle. So I can bring down my 4x squared, my middle terms, when I combine those, negative 8 minus 8 is negative 16x. And then we can bring down our plus 16. And so this will be my answer when I multiply those two binomials together. So again, I have a problem for you to try. I want you to try this one to see if you can multiply it out just like I did with this one. So first, you should have written 6p minus 1 twice, because that's what the power of 2 tells me. And then you want to draw out your box and write 6p minus 1 from the first binomial. And the second binomial, put 6p minus 1 on the side of the box, and you can use that for your multiplication. So I see that 6p times 6p is 36p squared, and then 6p times negative 1 is negative 6p, and then negative 1 times 6p is negative 6p, and negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. Then we write all the terms down, so I'll bring down the first term, bring down this one, bring down that one, bring down that one, and I'm going to combine my like terms to get negative 12p in the middle, but the 36p squared brings down and the 1 brings down. So this would be my answer here at the very bottom, once you've multiplied it and combined like terms. So for our final example for today, we can also find the area just like we did in the warm-up, but now instead of having a monomial here, I have a binomial multiplied by another binomial. So when I set this up, the area is the base times the height. So this value down here times this value over here. And this problem is now set up like the previous examples, where we're going to make our box. So we're going to construct our box and then write our binomials. My first binomial, x minus 3, goes on the top. 5x plus 2 goes on the side. And I can go through and multiply this out. If I multiply this out, I get 5x times 1x is 5x squared. 5x times negative 3 is negative 15x. 2 times 1x is 2x. And 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. And so when I bring these terms down, 5x squared minus 15x plus 2x minus 6, I know that I'm going to combine my like terms. So that's the negative 15x and the positive 2x. And that is going to be negative 13x. However, we're not finished, because we can bring down the 5x squared and we can bring down the minus 6. So this would represent my area of this rectangular figure here. 5x squared minus 13x minus 6. And so this is how we utilize the box method in order for us to find the product of two binomials.